Dry eye disease is very common, the major pathological factor being meibomian gland dysfunction. Aniridia-associated keratopathy is a major cause of visual dysfunction and is due to limbal stem cell deficiency. A couple of mechanisms have been advocated for causing glaucoma. One, the presence of tissue between the iris stump and angle, which eventually covers a significant portion of the angle wall. Two, avascular tissue that similarly closes off the angle. And three, absence of Schlemm's canal and trabecular meshwork abnormalities. Iris hypoplasia is the hallmark sign of aniridia and may vary from very minimal to iris tissue only observed by gonioscopy and anterior segment OCT. Cataract occurs in greater than 80 to 90% of patients and is often in the form of a polar cataract. Often there are also radiating posterior subcapsular opacities in the mid-peripheral region that later forms a ring on the posterior capsule. Foveal hypoplasia is present in up to 90% of cases and is associated with nystagmus. Most patients have a lighter than normal fundus color and impairment of red, green and blue-yellow color vision. Optic nerve hypoplasia has been reported in up to 30% of patients and is possibly related to the severity of the foveal hypoplasia. This list is not exhaustive but covers most of the important findings. Wager syndrome is an acronym for Wilms tumor, aniridia, genitourinary abnormalities and mental retardation and can be used even when there is aniridia with just one of the other conditions. It involves a deletion in PAX6 and WT1, the Wilms tumor predisposition gene.